park is home to over 150 animals, 50 different species that are native to Illinois. As you explore the park, you'll learn about wolves, bison, waterfowl, black bear, elk, cougar, otter, and much more. The park officially opened in 1978, founded by Hazel and Bill Rutherford. The park was originally a strip mining area and includes one strip mine and seven underground mines. that take place at Wildlife Prairie Park. You'll find places to eat, the adventure store, the visitor center, and the beginning of an incredible journey all overlooking the pasture featuring bison, the white bison, and elk. Hike Marathon's Loop and see the red fox, coyote, bobcat, black bear, and cougar. Ladies and gentlemen, we will soon be arriving at Pioneer Station. From here, you can visit the schoolhouse, Pioneer Farmstead, goats, and more.
It is also only about a 10-minute walk to the visitor center. For anyone wishing to leave the train, please remain seated until we have come to a full and complete stop, designated by a single whistle blast. Departure times from this station are posted near the entrance to the boarding area. Please watch your step.
Thank you.
Park and the Wildlife Prairie Park Railroad. For all of you train enthusiasts, our 1/3 scale train run on a 24-inch gauge track, which was hand-laid by our hard-working volunteers. Our black locomotive number 1978 and five of our passenger cars were built by Chance Rides and used to run at the St. Louis Zoo many years ago. Our red locomotive number 1914 was custom built for the park by volunteers. The remaining four passenger cars were built by Stanley Light Railway Equipment Works of Wisconsin Dells, Wisconsin, and were acquired from the Milwaukee County Zoo. A full ride on the Wildlife Prairie Park Railroad is a little over 2 miles long with a top speed of about 5 miles per hour. On the left side of the train, we passed one of our hobo kings. Hobos used to hitch a ride on trains and travel around the country looking for work. Keep an eye out. You never know if you might see a hobo trying to hop on board. Scattered throughout the park, you will see many bluebird houses. A sample house is coming up on the right side of the train. Bluebirds are important in our ecosystem because they consume large quantities of destructive insect matter. Because of the steady decline of these birds since the 1900s, Wildlife Prairie Park has established four bluebird gardens, little houses, which are monitored by dedicated volunteers. The recorded information allows us to help keep the Illinois bluebird population at healthy levels. We are headed to Wildlife Prairie Park's railroad maintenance area. Here is where most trains are housed in a tin shed during non-operating hours. The daily operations of our railroad are handled by about 25 volunteers. We need plenty of help to keep things running safely 7 days a week. From engineers to locomotive and track maintenance, there is always plenty to do. Simply contact the park if you're interested in being a Wildlife Prairie Park Railroad volunteer. To the right of the train is the home of our horses, Lily and Rascal. As mother and son, they have only been separated one time in their lives. When he was younger, a lump was noticed on Rascal's lower jaw that ended up being bone cancer. While one vet said the odds didn't look good, the vets at the University of Illinois decided to try a procedure via the internet with a veterinarian in England. The cancerous bone on the jaw was replaced with bone from his hip, which got rid of the cancer. The horse's story to people is to remember to get several opinions and enjoy life. They certainly are at Wildlife Prairie Park. Ladies and gentlemen, we will soon be arriving in Dolly Wobbler Station. Here you'll find swings also the beginning of the sliding door hiking trail, which will lead you down to the main parking lot and main visitor center. For anyone wishing to leave the train, please remain seated until we have come to a full and complete stop designated by a single whistle. Departure times for this station are posted near the entrance to the boarding area. Please watch your step. Your trip on the Wildlife Prairie Park Railroad. We remind you to please remain seated while the train is moving. The next stop is the main depot. As we make our way around the South Loop, we will be passing the beer pen to the right of the train, which can only be seen from the railroad. This is home to Brandon and Jersey. White-tailed deer tend to be most active at dawn and dusk. They have relatively small home ranges, usually only a square mile or less. You might not see them right away, but keep an eye out because they're watching out and we're moving. Side of the trees to the left is another one of our scenic trails, the Herbert B. White Hiking Trail. It will join the Whispering Hiking Trail and take you to Hazel's Hill or back to the main depot. Keep your eyes open during your visit and you are bound to spot a few bat boxes. The bats in Wildlife Prairie Park are insectivores, greatly helping to control the insect population. Bat droppings, or guano, can also be useful as a rich natural fertilizer. By having bat boxes throughout the park, we encourage the bats to stick around not only to help manage the bugs, they will roost in the boxes instead of inside buildings and pavilions. Visit, but we take our commitment to education very seriously. Ladies and gentlemen, we will soon be arriving at the main depot. Remember that your train ride today includes travel on both the north and south routes. So if you're continuing your journey, please remain in your seat. If you have completed both routes, please stay seated until you come to a full and complete stop at the platform designated by a single whistle. Please exit to the right of the train and watch your step as you leave. Thank you for riding the Prairie Zephyr on the Wildlife Prairie Park Railway.